Remember the time that we measured our hands together, but something happened, Merlin. In those days, your fingers were straight. I don't know what's happened now. Maybe you've been gripping too many flowers or too many microphones. I also have some fond memories of my playing days at Ohio State. A national championship, an Olympic gold medal, the Player of the Year award, and of course, the Sportsman of the Year. The Sportsman Award was quite a surprise for me that year, especially since that year Roger Maris hit 61 home runs and a certain Utah State tackle, you know, the one with the crooked fingers I just talked about, he won the Outland Trophy that year. The award, of course, was good for me, but I think it was also good for college basketball at that time because the game had gotten a pretty bad reputation because of some betting scandals, and I felt the reputation I had as a serious athlete and a conscientious student helped give college basketball a little boost in morale that it needed. My coach, Fred Taylor, always said the only points I really was worried about were the ones on my grade point average, and I think that he was right at that time in my life. I'll admit that my approach to basketball was very businesslike, to be sure, even though I took a lot of ribbing from my teammates at that particular time, especially some of them said that, well, Merlin, what they really said was that my outside shot looked kind of like a frog, and so I said, I suppose nobody could accuse me of being too flashy. I remember one Buckeye fan very clearly saying, I wonder how old Luke was when he was born. We sure had a unique team at Ohio State in those days, though. I think it was the only team in the history of college basketball to have five players go on and play professional basketball. The other players were John Havlicek, Larry Siegfried, of course, my teammate John is in the audience tonight, and the other two were Joe Roberts and Mel Noel. We all had different personalities, but we worked as one on the court. Good teamwork always gives the best results, as we shall see in this review of the major winter sports, college basketball, professional basketball, and ice hockey.
Of all the points that were scored in all the professional and amateur basketball leagues last season, this one basket in the middle of an otherwise inconsequential game is the one that got the most attention. This skyhook gave Kareem Abdul-Jabbar 31,421 career points and broke Wilt Chamberlain's NBA scoring record. The shot has been in Kareem's repertoire since he was a high school sensation named Lou Alcindor. As a star of three UCLA championship teams and through 16 NBA seasons, Jabbar has been so physically imposing that many have taken him for granted. Too much of what the big man accomplished seemed too easy, especially when the effort seldom showed. With his record, the affection for Jabbar has begun to match the admiration for his talents.
It is my great honor and pleasure to congratulate you on becoming the highest scorer in the history of the National Basketball Association.
1984 was also a notable year for this man, All-NBA forward Bernard King of the New York Knicks. King has had so many ups and downs in his career that he was named Comeback Player of the Year in 1981 as a Golden State Warrior at the unlikely age of 24. Last season, he became the scoring machine that experts always knew he could be. With this nearly unstoppable array of offensive tricks, King became the first player since Wilt Chamberlain to have back-to-back 50-point games on consecutive nights.
50-point games!
But no pro basketball player accomplished more than Sportsman of the Year candidate Larry Bird of the NBA champion Boston Celtics. Many experts say that the Celtic forward is the best all-around player in the game today. Bird is the kind of all-out competitor who'll go man-to-man or jaw-to-jaw with anyone. Whether maneuvering inside or driving from the outside, Bird was always in full flight. In the championship series against the Lakers, the Celtics had to go 7 topsy-turvy games to win. Bird was voted MVP for the playoffs, and the league's MVP as well. One of the few times a forward has gained that honor.
I just want to say I'm very proud to be a Boston Celtics. It's been a great honor for me to show my talents in Boston. The fans have been great, the players have been great, and the coach has even been great. We had a lot of heart and a lot of desire, and it carried over and we won a championship. it's been a great honor for me to play in the NBA, and I hope my continued success to myself and to my teammates, and I just want to win some more rings. Thank you very much.
In college basketball, the player of the year was the wondrous Michael Jordan of North Carolina. Jordan has been touted as pound for pound, inch for inch, the most exciting player in the game. Jordan's talents became even more apparent in the Olympics, where he was the main attraction of a one-sided basketball show. In the NCAA tournament, however, victory went to this star and this team, and most importantly to this man and his unshakable fate in his own way of doing things. The star is Pat Ewing, a Jamaican immigrant who grew up in Boston, and the team is Georgetown, so deep, so menacing that it barely mattered which of its regulars was on the court. The coach is John Thompson, who won his first national championship final in his 12th year at Georgetown. Thompson became the first black coach ever to win any major NCAA Division I title.